Hi guys, how are you doing? Welcome back to the channel, Neil here, and today we are checking out this absolutely stunning new guitar from a new brand in 2024. This is the Spira S507 and it is absolutely stunning to look at, that's for sure. In today's video we're going to find out exactly what it sounds like and how it plays. Okay guys, so I don't think anyone can deny that Spira have made quite a large entrance in just a couple of months into the metal world for guitars. You know, they look absolutely fantastic. My views on my first video of my S400 are really, really high, especially for a new guitar brand. So I'm really happy with that. This guitar that we're looking at today is a Spira 507. Now, just before we look at this guitar, I'm gonna let you know exactly what I'm using in this video. So the Spira 507 is going directly straight into my Sonic Matrix Box 2. If you're in the market for a really affordable, awesome sounding processor, you know, with all the amp models and everything like that on, then it really is worth looking at. The Matrix Box 2 to me is absolutely awesome. I've used it in loads of demos. If you're interested in purchasing the Matrix Box 2 or any other Sonic 8 gear at all, please check out the link below in the description. It's an affiliate link, so it helps support me and what I do at this end. But also, if you use code Neil, you can get 10% off once you've gone through that link. Another thing that I should probably tell you guys about is that now you can download my presets. So basically, if you guys are interested in my presets and you want a Sonic 8 Matrix Box 2, then let me know. Drop me an email at 9cornneilpresets@gmail.com. I'll get back to you, and for just $9.99, I will send you my presets that I use on this channel. Right, moving on to this awesome guitar. I've not had a 7-string on the channel before at all. I can't believe that, actually. So this is the first 7-string on the channel, and it's a really good one. This retails at €529 over here in the UK, give or take, depending on where exactly you buy it. I will put a link to the Spira website down there below in the description for you guys to check out. So my first impression of this guitar are, wow, the top is absolutely awesome. I love the way it looks. It really does look like a very expensive guitar, and it's not at all. You do get with this guitar, as you can see there, a string dampener, which goes between the nut and the tuners. These are needed on these guitars, and I think that's why you get them free with it. These are very, very loud resonant guitars. When they're not even plugged in, they are loud, and there's a lot of vibration going on, and you really do need a string dampener there. As I said before in the S400 demo, I absolutely love the headstock styling, you know, the shape of it and everything. And I think the chrome logo on there looks absolutely awesome. It really is classy and it really does look great. The neck on this guitar, guys, is down as a D-shaped neck, but it feels like a C to me. I describe this as a modern C. It's pretty slim for a 7-string, you know, it's pretty nice to move around. And I've got small hands and I don't use 7-strings that much. You know, I've not used one for a while, so it was a bit daunting at first playing a 7-string, but once I got used to it, you know, I made use of the neck, and I think the neck feels absolutely great. You know, to say it's a 7-string neck and I have small hands, I've got no issues at all with the neck. And the finish on the back there, if you can see it, is super, super silky satin and super smooth when you're playing. I I absolutely love the back of the body of the guitar. You can see the mahogany body through there, through the finish. I think it looks absolutely great. I really love that. And I think it blends well with the top as well. This is a veneer on the top, I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, but it really does look great, that maple veneer on there. The neck, by the way, is a roasted Canadian maple neck, and it does look absolutely gorgeous, and it smells really good too. We have an ebony board on this guitar. The scale length is 26.5. Some of you guys who play baritones will be used to longer scales. I'm not, so at first, like I say, it was a bit daunting, but once I got used to it, it's a really comfortable neck. Plays really, really well. The frets on there are down as jumbo frets, but they're not quite as large as some jumbo frets. They don't get in the way. Sometimes I think with jumbo frets, especially when you're sliding, you feel like you're bouncing around and bouncing over them, kind of like road bumps. But these frets are pretty easy to maneuver around, and the guitar sounds awesome as well. This guitar is in B standard today, guys, and the pickups that we have in here are Villain pickups. These are made specifically by Spira for Spira guitars. They're designed for them. They're quite a dark, chunky, clean sounding pickup. There's plenty of punch there, and to be honest, in this 7-string, they do sound really, really good, especially for a guitar at this price point. Probably should point out the bridge on this guitar, guys. It's a strange one for me. I've not really seen a bridge like that before. It's kind of Spira's version, I guess, of, you know, a hip shot, but not quite as much metal there. The metal is quite thin. It's a really comfortable bridge though, and you kind of don't feel it under your hand. It's kind of like, it's really low profile, like you'd expect from a hardtail bridge, I guess is what I'm trying to say. But yeah, it's really reliable. I've had no issues with the bridge whatsoever. This guitar that I'm playing today is actually straight out of the box. I tweaked the truss rod on the S400, but on this 507, I didn't feel the need to tweak anything. I've just played it straight out of the box, and I think you'll agree, it sounds plays great. We'll be right back. talk about the tuners on this guitar, guys. There are Spirit logos on the tuners, which I absolutely love that touch. I think it's a real nice touch. Again, like the logo on the headstock, it keeps the guitar looking classy and it keeps the guitar looking like it is a lot more expensive than it actually is. These are locking tuners, guys. Now, Spirit didn't have to put locking tuners on these guitars, but they did, and I think that's really great. I love locking tuners, and to be honest, I think locking tuners should be on every guitar anyway. Whether it's got a Floyd or whether it's a hardtail, stop tail, whatever, locking tuners are the future, in my opinion. The nut on here, guys, I've just read the specs, and it's actually a bone nut on there. It looks a really good nut, actually, and it feels pretty good quality. Better quality than you would expect on a guitar at this price point, again, in my opinion. The access up high, guys, is great. As you can see, it's pretty well cut away there. Nothing is in the way, and it's about as good as it gets. As always, guys, please do not forget to let me know in the comments below what you think of this guitar and what you think of Spirit guitars. I think they've made a massive entrance, you know, and I'm really hoping that they're going to make other guitars, you know, at a higher price point, maybe the £1,000, £1,400 rate, because I think they'll do an absolutely awesome job of it. They've started off really well, and yeah, I absolutely love what they're trying to do. If you guys want to buy any gear at all, please note that down below in the description there's a Thomann affiliate link, and there's also an Anderton's affiliate link as well. Anytime you go through those links and purchase anything at all, it helps support me at this end. As I always say, guys, it doesn't matter what I say in these reviews, these demos, whatever you want to call them. It only matters what you guys think. Use your ears, not mine. Let me know what you think of this guitar down below, and I'll see you all very soon.